In the next few topics of the course, we're going to look at some of the major metabolic pathways having to do with how the body uses food to obtain energy and build molecules that it needs. The pathways are summarized in this diagram, which at first glance may look pretty complicated. But if you break it down into its components and understand how the different parts fit together, it should start to make sense. For example, notice that three molecules are central in these processes: glucose-6-phosphate, pyruvate, and acetyl-CoA. If you understand the various fates of these three compounds, then the entire diagram will make a lot more sense. Different parts of the diagram are covered in different topics. We'll look at the top part of the diagram in the carbohydrate metabolism topic. This will cover glycogen synthesis and breakdown, glycolysis, which goes from glucose to pyruvate, fermentation, which goes from glucose to lactate or ethanol, gluconeogenesis, in which lactate or pyruvate or some other compounds can be used to make glucose, and the pentose phosphate pathway, which is useful for making NADPH and ribonucleotides. The next topic will cover oxidation of pyruvate to acetyl-CoA and carbon dioxide, and the oxidation of carbons in the citric acid cycle to produce the reduced electron carriers NADH and QH2. In this topic, we'll also touch briefly on how other molecules, such as amino acids, are made. In the topic on oxidative phosphorylation, we'll see how electrons from glycolysis and the citric acid cycle are used to synthesize ATP. And then we'll look at synthesis and breakdown of fatty acids, and talk about the role of ketone bodies in energy metabolism. After going through all the pathways, I'll try to summarize how they fit together in the fed and unfed states. By that time, you should understand this diagram pretty well and be able to explain how the different pathways fit together.